Good evening. Here is Nabil with you, and in today's tutorial, we will learn how to control in the real time a servo motor angular rotation from a Python GUI. So let's dive in. First of all, we have to set up the embedded software to the Arduino development board, and that will be basically constituted of the standard Firmata client protocol program. To reach there, we have to follow the following steps. Firstly, plug in the Arduino to the PC or the Raspberry Pi, depending on your situation, and select the appropriate port name in the Arduino IDE. Secondly, from the IDE drop-down menu, we have to click on File, Examples, Firmata, and finally on Standard Firmata. In the end, we have to compile and upload the code. The next step is the hardware wiring of the servo with the Arduino board. Before we begin, we have to take in account that most servos come with three leads: the power, the plus 5 volt, the ground, the minus, and the PWM signal or the data wire. These three servo leads usually come in different color patterns. So in order to distinguish between the three leads, here is some of the universal servo color codes. After recognizing the three leads, we will connect them to our development board in the following fashion. The ground and the 5 volts of the servo will go respectively to the 0 and 5 volts on the board. For the signal wire, we will choose to connect it to the digital pin number 9, but it can be connected to any of the digital pins that is supporting the PWM mode, which are, in the case of the Arduino Uno, the pins number 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, or 11. And finally, we will still need the serial port, USB port, in my case, COM7, for the Firmata protocol serial communication. For now, let's build up our graphic user interface by implementing a couple of libraries. The first library, pyFirmata, that would handle Firmata protocol. The second library, Tkinter, that would help us construct the graphic user interface. Then specify the correct serial port, which is in my case COM7. After that, launch an iterator thread so the serial buffer won't be compromised and overflow. And finally, set up the digital pin number 9 as output and of a servo mode. Now let's code the slider widget with the scale function with a maximum of 180 degrees, 400 pixels of width, horizontal orientation, and of a callback function, move servo, that has an implicit argument, the actual value of the slider that we will use to rotate our servo with. And as a final touch, the Tkey constructor will initiate the top window labeled root. And finally, the root main loop to keep the program running.
Now let's warm up our project and make the simulation and practice what we have been preaching. So for that, I will launch the Arduino IDE. So here, now it's launching. Here I have already the standard Firmata, but I will show you how to get this program. So we will go to file examples, Firmata, standard Firmata. So here it is. We have to select the correct port name. Here we have a COM tree. I had already plugged the Arduino to my PC. And then I will compile and upload my code to the development board. Here it showed that the uploading is done without any complication. For the Python program, I had already created an empty file and I named it firmata-servo.py. And I will open it in the Python IDE, and I had already pasted all the code I had explained. So, and now I will proceed to run it. And a window is popping up containing the slider. And as I move the slider, you can hear the servo making the sound and make copying the exact angle that is showing on the slider. Here is the hardware setup, and as you can see here, there is a servo with the three leads, and each lead is connected respectively to the Arduino development board, as we had already explained. And you can see here the PC, and since the PC is running on Windows, I have the COM7 for the serial communication, but it's still portable. And if you have a Mac or a Linux or Raspberry Pi, it should be different, but it's still portable. It's working just fine. Here we can see I shoot this video so to show you how it is running in this real time and copying the exact angular rotation.
In the end, I hope you had learned how easy it is to drive any servo motor from your human machine interface. I have left as a reference the repository of the complete code to download in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you really like the content. I hope to see you very soon in the future videos. Tata for now!